Hello and welcome to my next class. Today we have come up with a lecture on Elizabethan poetry and the very important of all, a passionate poet, that is Spenser. But before we begin, we get to know about more about Spenser and his poetry. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and please like the video. Now, who was Spenser? He belonged to a poor Langshaw family. He was born in London about 1552. His important works are The Shepherd's Calendar, Astrophel, Collins' Clouds Come Home Again, The Emoretti, The Epithalamion, The Four Hymns to Love and Beauty, and The Fairy Queen. Of all, why Spenser is known is because of Fairy Queen. Now, Spenser, when we talk about Spenser, he was the man of his times. He was the foremost poet of English poetry in the 16th century. He was a passionate poet and his works reflect the religious and humanist ideals. He belonged to a poor family and he was born in London, that is 1552. And I told you about his important works. Now we will discuss one by one each and every work to what he has written and to what he tries to represent through his works. They are very important works. So please concentrate and just try to learn and understand each and every point so that it can be there in your memory and you will remember at the time of your examination. So, let's begin with The Shepherd's Calendar. It is a pastoral poem carved on Theocritus and Virgil and their Italian and French followers of the Renaissance. Now, when we talk about The Shepherd's Calendar, this was his first major poetic work. And through this poem, it is based on Theocritus and Virgil and followers and their followers, their Italian and French followers of Renaissance. Okay. Now, this poem consists of 12 eclogues, one for each month of the year. Alright, means in every month he has explained something or the other. This poetry is full of, as I said, it is a pastoral poem. Pastoral is giving help and advice on personal matters. Now, he has carved it so beautifully. The language used in it, the vocabulary that he has borrowed from foreign vocab, and the allegory that is represented throughout this poem is very interesting. Now, you will say what allegory is. It is a literary device and it is used to represent characters or events in a form of symbols, in a fictional form of picture, and so that it can give you some message out of that. For more details, you go to my next lecture where I've explained what pastoral is, what allegory is. So go on with that lecture and you will understand. So coming back to this poetry, in this poem, poet name is Colin Cloud. Now, when this poem starts, in this poem, the poet's name is Colin Cloud. And in the starting, Colin, rejected by his beloved Rosalind, compares his mood with the wintry landscapes. In the very first stanza, or you can say in the very first eclogue, in the very first month, that is January, he was rejected by his beloved, that is Rosalind, and he compares his mood with the wintry landscapes. And so on, the poem goes on. In this poem, archaic language is used, and here England is represented as a vast sheep farm which is ruled by a shepherd named as Queen Eliza. And the Queen Eliza's beauty is described by a poem in the month of April. This is an important question, and it is asked in every NET examination, that in which month poet describes the beauty of Eliza, that is in the month of April. As now things have changed, and so they can give you a paragraph or so where he has described the beauty of Eliza. You can go through that. I will give you it in the quotes. Learn that so that you should know about the beauty that he describes in the month of April. It's very easy but important. Okay, now moving ahead with his next poem, that is Astrophel and Colin Clouds Come Home Again. When we talk about Astrophel, it is a pastoral elegy on the death of Sir Philip Sidney. Here poet grieves, and he has written an elegy on a noble man on the death of Sir Philip Sidney. And it is in the form of allegory. Again, allegory, I've explained you number of times, and you can go to my lecture where I've explained allegory, pastoral and all. So please go through that lecture. So Astrophel, please remember, it is a pastoral elegy on the death of Sir Philip Sidney. Now Colin's Cloud is an important and another pastoral poem, which is counted the most lively poems of Spenser. This is the autobiographical work, and it is important. Why? Because in this poem, poet shares his experience of his first visit to England, where he is introduced to Queen Elizabeth. When he visited England in the year 1589 to 90, he was introduced by Sir Walter Raleigh to Queen Elizabeth, where he got the idea of writing Fairy Queen. So he shares his experience of that visit in his poem Colin's Cloud Come Home Again. Okay, now moving on with the next poem, The Emoretti and the Epithalamion. Now this is a beautiful poem. He writes the sonnet when he returns back to Ireland. While he returns back, he writes this. And when he fell in love with Elizabethan Boyle, he records his emotions and feelings in a series of sonnet called Emoretti. And the concluding part of these sonnet are called as Epithalamion or Bridal Ode. Right. Now, when we talk about the Epithalamion, it is a long stanza of 17, 18 or 19 lines, and the last being a refrain that echoes throughout the poem. It is not only the best bridal poem in the language, but the best of all Spenser's work. This is the best of all Spenser's work. We all know that Fairy Queen is his greatest poem, but Epithalamion is certainly the best and most delightful poems of all. When we talk about Epithalamion or the Emoretti, when he recorded his emotions in the series of sonnet, and that was named as Emoretti, you know, there were different sonnets, and the distinction of Spenser's sonnet is that the love expressed in them was real and not pretended. That means the feelings that he shared in his sonnets were real, and he did not pretend those feelings because he was in love with Elizabethan Boyle. And there was a concluding part, as I told you, that was Epithalamion. Then there was a work, please note that there was a work, Prothalamion. And this was written in the honor of double marriage of two daughters of Earl of Worcester. There was also a poem, The Four Hymns to Love and Beauty. And this poem was in praise of earthly love and beauty. These two poems were also written by Spenser. Next, we'll come up with the Fairy Queen. As Fairy Queen is very important, so I will take it in my another lecture. Don't forget these two poems to Prathamelian and the four hymns to love and beauty, in which he has written in his youth days, or you can say in the greener days. And he amended these and added two more in honor of heavenly love and heavenly beauty. That is four hymns to love and beauty. So don't forget these works. They are very important. So I will come up with my next lecture, that is Fairy Queen. Don't forget to subscribe and share my channel. Thank you.